Hello, and welcome to Chase Race, number 8 of the Season 4 Intersol Universal Orlando Cup Series, here at an Intersol favorite known as Pig's Creek. The Outback Xfinity Series race had two wrecks take place, take out some good contenders, and in the end, the points battle really shook up. However, in this series here, everyone is in trouble with the exception of Chris Washer. And literally everyone that Chase that's here needs to get a good run. Even Levi McIntyre is 20 points back, who's second in points. If any of the drivers are 32 points or behind more, then Chris Washer will automatically be the Season 4 champion. Now, get you to your starting lineup. Stephen Pauly, third, will take the pole. Second is JT Bryant. Third, Trent Dunham. Fourth, Anthony Ritchie. Fifth is Nathan Hutson. Sixth, Tanner Sullivan. Seventh is PJ Williams. Eighth is Clint Spillman. Ninth is Michael Waltz. Being a top 10 is Scott Commons. Who's Rutsu starting lineup from 11th on back? And there is Washer. A lot of eyes are going to be on him these next three races, especially if a choke happens in this race. Who will capitalize and who will fail? On the final row, we have Nuvier and Jackie Tang. So Stephen Pauly the third in the Jetta here. It's going to be just a second. Moving this out of the way here. Pauly the third had a struggling chase. Although with his good runs as of late, he has caught up back into the hunt, but he really needs a good run as here comes the command to fire him up here at Pig's Creek. As there's the command. They really need the 35 car to get involved in a wreck and be the first retiree after that. It is fair game. And remember, if a chaser wins, 16 points are on the line. All 42 cars get going. Great sight to see right there. Pauly of the third. Pauly of the third, JT Bryant, the Mobile One Jetta. And the Perrier Ford. Front row is all chasers there. JT Bryant, 2 points ahead of Pauly the third. And literally, I kid you not, Chris Washer just ahead of 20 points over Levi McIntyre. And Levi McIntyre on down to, or even Johnny Gardner, James Qualzar, they are desperate for good runs, because if not, they're done. And they're all like bunched around together. So time is running out. Some drivers are going to be cut from championship contention after this race. Pace cars down the pit road. Eyes are going to be on that outside line, number 35 BMW, to see if they can pick up their first ever championship. 18 laps of action. The green flag is out. We are underway here at Pig's Creek for Chase Race number 8 here in Canada. Trent Dunham wasting no time whatsoever for St. Keith Motorsports, trying to go for the lead, wasting no time whatsoever. Tanner Sullivan falling to the back. Michael Walton coming up to the front of the field. Walton's had a very quiet chase. He wants to make something good for it this season. There's Chris Washer in the 35 in the middle of the pack. That is not where you want to be, especially if you're the points leader. Literally, chases are all around everywhere, and they'll tell you something. If that 35 car gets through the top runners of the championship battle and finishes really well again, he'll be season 4 champion easy. His goal is the drivers to be at least 32 or more behind or to clinch the title. However, we still got a race to do right here, and the racing is really heating up as lap one's completed. Anthony Ritchie leads it down. Oh, he got spinning! Oh my god, Nathan Hutson, I think, died. Oh my god. That was a terrible crash. Hutson, Tanner Sullivan, that's a chase contender. There goes one. Nathan McCurry. Oh no, not the bridge, not the bridge. Oh, Poteet! No! CFO numbers! Oh, man! Oh, there's another spin! Washer gets by that one. That's McIntyre. That's second in the points. He's going to continue. He's got a lot of damage. That is not good. Washer gets by another one. Skycom and T's heading down pit road at the moment. And I mean, down there saying it was Power Quest in the 95. That is a tough blow right there. Levi McIntyre is going to stay out. I don't blame the 19 there. Only chaser down pit road, that's Tanner Sullivan. That, I think that may have just sealed the deal for the Mountain Dew Code Red Ford there. Tanner Sullivan was one of those drivers that was tied with JT Bryant. Reckon I pencil guys there. And they were about, let's see, 7 points behind Levi. About 27 back, and that probably may have just ended it right there for Tanner Sullivan. Unless if that 35 gets involved, that's something the only way I could see he could still be contention. All the smoke kicking up from the incidents taking place. Your leader, Power Quest. Let's take a look what happened. Let's take a look at Tanner Sullivan right here. He actually bounced off the wall. Him and Michael Walton actually got a little piece of it. But Tanner really got the wall. That's what killed his momentum. And the first thing I would tell you is, what was Hudson thinking right here? Just fits enough there, but he just kind of gets the corner panel just enough. Goes into McCurry and a Davis. Davis keeps it going. And watch the two with Sullivan. I thought it was Hudson that did this. Oh, man. And actually, Chris Washer barely got by that wreck. We mean barely. Boy, did he get lucky on that one. Tanner Sullivan. That's JT Barr right there in that green Perrier 4. That's his teammate. Bad sight to see right there. Nothing could have seen your teammate fly in the air. So that's what happened with that part of the incident. Now, let's go take a look up ahead. Okay, now this area, this is bad. We gotta go to Levi. Now, Levi McIntyre in the Subway Toyota. If I can get this set up. Does it keep in the crap? There we go. Alright, take a look. The first contact is gonna be, oh man, Devin Becker poked Pete Louvière, getting to set Cole Matthews, Mongold, Charles Samper, Levi McIntyre. That's two more. Get a helicopter here. The rest of the chasers get by right there. There's where Commons gets involved. Michael Walton almost gets involved right there. Nice move by the 99 just to avoid it. And then here comes the rest of the pack that was just getting held up from the mess. And I believe Kyle Cisnowski was the one that ran over Levi, and indeed it was. That's what's going to get him his front end damage because of the Hooters Ford right there. That was just a low blow move by Cisnowski, and it's kind of good seeing that he's not going to be back next season there because of that move. So that was look what happened. Let's take it back to the live action where we get you back to the green. Well, we are back in an update on who's out of the race. We have two chasers out. I believe Levi McIntyre and Tanner Sullivan, also outer Anthony McCurry and Kyle Cisnowski. Now Tanner, at this point, I believe it is safe to say he has been eliminated in mathematical competition. However, Levi, because he only got 2 points, if Chris Washer finishes better, way, way, way ahead of Levi, and not like where JT Bryant's at, Levi's out of it. So, all eyes again on the 35. Top 10 rundown is Power Quest, Ian Dunham, Michael Norman, Cody Lamas, Kyle Miller. Highest ranked chasers, Kyle Miller in the 43, Mason Powers, Jonathan Zorlin, Jackie Tang, Chris Louvière, and Seth Pohl. That completes your top 10. Here we go. Green flag is back underway here at the Pigs Creek Super Speedway here as Ian Dunham decided to go on the outside line. That was not a good idea. The outside line is not a good line to use in the turns. Inside line is, and Michael Norman is going to take the advantage. Miller in the 43 would be the highest running chaser at the moment. The DeWalt Ford right there trying to get up to the front of the field. Hopefully not have to deal with the points leader right there. Kyle Keith now ahead of the 43 car. The DC Solar Chevrolet. And Paul III's now making an appearance. James Qualls, who suddenly found a little surge as of late. And Johnny Carter, Jessica Shelton, they're wasting no time whatsoever. These guys are trying to stay up there, and there it's very silently lurking, that 35 car, actually passing his old ride right there, the 5, which is now driven by Anthony Ritchie. He was returning next season to that car. Last score, the 35 car was 31st on the track. Charles Sanford just off the pace. Right off the pace, and then these guys, yeah, they're out of it. Keith, now the new leader. Here comes Shelton and Gardner. Two chasers up here. They're four wide. Very wise, that's what you want to be in this area. Five wide would not be the best idea. If you go four wide, it's really good. Oh, my God. PJ Williams kind of crowded Caleb Harris and Seth Cole right there. I don't know what the 88 is thinking right there. These guys are racing very wide, very tough, very competitive. These guys can make one little slip and it's all over. And Chris Washer has now made an appearance in the front of the field. That is killer for the chasers. Oh, he nearly got turned right there. Jessica Shelton trying to get that outside line going. She's going to lead the lap. Oh, and right in front of the field. The caution's out. That's James Qualls. That just sealed his fate. Oh, and a terrible crash. Kyle Keith, another chaser. That goes his chance. Kyle Miller, Charles Sanford, Michael Walton. The other chasers are just getting involved, and this is sealing the fate for Chris Washer's championship. Dave is smoking. He is done. These guys are racing back. You thought the crazy racing's over. It ain't. A lot of people were hoping that 35 car was going to get involved in a wreck. It looks like that may not be the case. Chris Washer has just been that survivor this entire chase. No one has been able to compete with him. At the line, Marco Martinez is going to lead them down. And that 35 in the 8th position has cautions out on lap 10 of 18, past the halfway point. Johnny Gardner, PowerQuest, we're leaning on each other right there, but they wisely settled down. Man, that just, I can't believe that. Kyle Keith, Charles Sanford, Michael Walton, that may have sealed it for them. James Qualls, that may have just definitely sealed it for him. Keith just had enough damage just for that car to smoke, and now he is out of here. There goes his chase. There's JT Bryant, way behind from all what happened. Kyle Miller in the 43. Mason Powers got the front end damage, I think, as he ran into someone there. So, only ones in this pack that are here are Paul III, Trent Dunham, Chris Washer, Johnny Gardner, Jessica Shelton and Marco Martinez, like about the width. The caution's out. Let's take a look what happened. Well, I think this is why Chris Washer's getting the championship. The other chasers just keep getting involved in accidents. This may be the first time ever we're going to have one this early on, winning a championship for one driver. And I think the contact where this is going to start, oh, Zorlin going into Jackie Tang, going into Kyle Miller right there. And Miles goes up, gets into Qualls and Duncan, and then it just goes on from there. Look at the spectator cam, just all the cars really get involved, but we got to go to helicopter here real quickly. Now, the UC driver spin out. Watch Kyle Keith just gets involved in 20. Actually, the 20 goes over the 42 there, but that's really how he got involved right there. Qualls actually nearly flipping over. Same for Vulcan. However, the 99 car does, of Walton, I'm curious to know how he flipped. There's Miller getting involved there, couldn't avoid hitting that wall. And then Charles Sanford in the 03, Couldn't avoid Benjamin Miles, man. Just didn't even slow down. Wow, Michael Walton really took a flip there in that Tony the Tiger forward. Man, he was in the back of that pack, too. Let's take a look real quickly here when we go to the start finish line, right? Right here. Right, let's see what happened to Walton, how he flipped over. Right, boom, that's Kyle Keefe and Joshua Balkan. Here's to know, what happens to car number 99? Gets through Tang, gets through Duncan, nope, oh, Jess gets it. And look, you get the wall kind of squeezed, and oh, Miles' car kind of stopped Walton. The impact and that force kind of really got the 99 right there. Wow, that's a terrible impact right there. The 99's going to be flipping over with the help of the 81 there. And literally tumbling down the front stretch banking of turn number one. Wow, and just eventually land on four wheels, I believe, but he took a ride, did that 99 car, and indeed he didn't land on four wheels, so terrible accident taking place here in turn number one, involving quite a few of chasers, but Chris Washer, in that 35, this is helping him more and more, and I'll tell you something, those strategies of qualifying in the back from the points leader, and just letting the chasers wreck each other, it's just been playing the favor of car number 35. Let's take you back to the green. So many laps to go we're going to have to see the finish of the race. The pace cars are giving us one lap to go. Out of the race include the following: Charles Samper, Michael Walton, Dr. Balkan, Kyle Keith, and William Duncan. Five chasers are out of it. Five. Also, Benjamin Miles is out of the race as well in car number 33. James Glaw's got his damage repaired. He's back on track. He has extended Sam pit road, but they got out just in time. Everybody else, they're just trying to do what they can, and the chasers have got to work together to get by the 35. It's just they haven't seemed to be on point. So when we go back to green, it will be five laps to go to determine the winner of this race. And to see if Chris Washer may have clinched the title early. Mark Martinez, he's your leader. Second is Jessica Shelton. Third, Cody Lombs. Fourth, Ian Dutta. Fifth, Caleb Harris. Sixth, PowerQuest. Seventh, Johnny Gardner. Eighth, Chris Washer. Eyes are going to be on him at all times. Ninth, Seth Cole. Coming in the top ten is Clint Spillman. Rest of the chasers, Trent Deming, 11th. Paul III in 16th. As the green flags back out. Kyle Miller, 21st. JT Bryant, 25th. Oh, someone blew up! It's part of the third. There goes another one. Unbelievable. James Qualls, there he is. And wow, I can't believe it. Another chaser just blew the motor. It was the pole sitter. Another one for Chris Washer. Yes, I know. I pulled a DJ Khalid. Scary. Trent Dunne, though, trying to hunt down that 35 car. And these guys have got to work together who are in this chase. Make sure that 35 stays behind. I would take out the 35 if I have to. I wouldn't care. Oh, if they're trying to limp onto pit road. But in the meantime, Lamas, Tutta, West, Paris, Martinez, Washer, Dunham, May, Williams, Shelton, Batson, and others. They're trying to battle for this win. Lamas has got the lead right now, trying to end his season on a high note. They're going five wide for Spahn, and Martinez just got the wall a bit. However, because he's really well adapted into the pack, I don't think he's going to lose it. So that's a good thing for the 11. Chris Washer just picking off the chasers one by one. Where's Pollard? There he is. He's wisely on the apron. Going back up the track. I don't know why. But he is going to hit the pit road, so no problems whatsoever. Thank God. DJ Williams, now the new leader. Devin Becker, popping in the second spot. Trent Dunham, now the highest running chaser. But now Chris Washer says, nope, not today. I'm going for that top spot for the chase. This is where that outside line is going to get a good run coming off of turn four there. This is where you want to be on the white flag lap coming off that turn. He's on that outside line because Trent Dunham, he really got a great run. and got ahead of Washer. Someone brake checked. I think that was, there was a green car. That was Alex May, number 30. And he held up Jessica Sheldon and Anthony Ritchie. I think as he was trying to avoid hitting the wall. I don't blame Alex May for doing that, but that really just killed Jessica Sheldon's momentum. However, they'll be back up into the pack with no problem. Now, Washer. In a bigger buzzkill. He's going for the lead. Man, he's trying to put bigger pressure on the Chasers to get those points and clinch the championship this early on. We've never had that in the NRSL before in any of the series. And we've only had it early on in the Outback Xfinity series as Quest almost turned Clint Spillman when Kate Anderson clinched the title after Chase Race 9 at FTF. Washer, coming to two laps to go, is the leader. Becker going to fall victim on the outside line. Washer going to use the low line. Marco Martinez, JT Bryant is back in the picture. Where did the 22 come from? He said, not today, I'm not giving up. Martinez, now hunting Chris Washer down. Oh, contact. They're keeping together somehow, and they're not going to wreck. Thank God. They were bouncing off each other, including the 52 and 77. They were rubbing doors. Now they're going to go four wide for the lead, and now they're going to put Chris Washer away. Now he's on the high line. This is a bad high line where he's in. This is where the high line gets no run whatsoever. This is where he could really fall back. This is where every chaser that's there in that pack must get by him. We are coming to the white flag here for the final time this race. White flag is out. One lap to go here at Pigs Creek. Washer got a good run right there. He's going to get around Marco Martinez. Meanwhile, battle for the lead. Keith Acton's going to get that lead. Barely got it, but that outside line is going to get that run. Come off the exit of the turn. Trent Dunham trying to get that lead. Oh, God. No, 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 no. No, don't wreck. Don't wreck. They just wrecked in front of the field. Chris Washer gets involved. Oh, and a terrible crash has happened. Dunham involved. Harden Wall. He's upside down. Other chases involved, but Washer gets by. He continues. That may have just sealed the fate. B.J. Williams, however, trying to run away with this lead. Trent Dunham, Marco Martinez. Do they have a chance? It may not be it, though. Johnny Gardner nearly just turned Trent Dunham, but that may have just been it. Coming to the checkered flag, B.J. Williams and the Hot Wheels Chevrolet will win at Pigs Creek as a terrible crash happened on the backstretch. Chris Washer survives it all. He will end up in the 12th position. Oh, you have got to be kidding me. Jessica Sheldon, that may have sealed her fate. That may have just sealed every fate of the championship right there. They need that 35 to get involved heavily in that wreck. And unfortunately, that did not happen at all. Oh my God. The only chasers have finished ahead of the 35 were Trent Dunham, Johnny Gardner, Marco Martinez. And that was about it. Everyone else got involved. Wow, that... I don't know what to say on that one there. I really don't. B.J. Williams, though, is the winner. We're going to step aside, take a look what brought ourselves the final wreck that ended today's race on the last lap there. Let's take a look what happened. Well, this bridge has been nothing but absolute cancer in the past. This bridge has just been unbelievable. The contact, I believe, is going to start with two different incidents. There you see a six wide. That was Bryant, Davis, Dunham, Shelton, and Ritchie. And then Seth Cole. Oh, I thought Seth Cole got down to Washer. However, Lou Vieira actually turned Washer up into JT Bryant. He actually slides up. Washer's still in the midst of the wreck. And he gets by it. Unbelievable. And then this is where it gets bad. Cars are sliding down that infield there. And, oh man, Dutta, Jessica Shelton, Seth Cole, Anthony Ritchie, all take hard hits. Look at the air. The 52 base. Wow, Power Quest went through the middle. JT Bryant gets involved right there. Heavy impact. The 5 flips over. Oh, my God. That's terrible. That's 4 cars. That was nearly like Season 2 when Dustin Telepass took that wild ride there where 6 cars literally hit that wall. And the 5 of Ritchie just went for a tumble to the Camping World Chevrolet. Bounced off Jessica Sheldon, that ended her car right there. And then Anthony Ritchie bounces off Seth Cole right there. Katie Bryant. West, there's Washer. We got to get on board that car there. And PJ Williams just won that race. That was awesome. But well, I think that may be safe to say that why Chris Washer is going to be champion. We got to get on board the 35 and show you his move that may have just sealed that championship for the Dunlop BMW. Well, this one again. There's his damage, and look at that. He gets by the wreck. Spectacular. And there you see him wrecking behind. Oh my God. I think that was Anthony Ritchie with all the air that he had right there. We really got to take a look at his view right there. This is from inside the cup. Just walked one. Or excuse me, that was Anthony Ritchie. My apologies, I meant to say Ritchie. I don't know why I said Wash. But watch this, though. Oh, man, this is where it gets really bad. Right about now. Oh, my God. Terrible crash that happened right there. 4 of the 5 team landed upside down right by the 52. How's look what happened? And we got word, we got a flyby view of that wreck down the backstretch. We gotta take a look at this. This is from the spectator cam, heading down the backstretch. Watch this view and watch the wrecking taking place, especially coming to that inside wall. Oh my God, that was Ian Dunne who really pounded that wall right there. And there's Anthony Ritchie who just went airborne right there. Wow, what a terrible crash that was there. So now I'm going to be away real quickly as we'll show you the results in just a second, and we'll see if Chris Washer has indeed clinched the championship. Okay, we are back, and we just want to document first off that every driver involved in that last wreck is okay, especially Ian Dunne and Anthony Ritchie really pounded the wall. Jessica Sheldon was all right. She got helped. Everybody else was all good. That was some good news. Now, about the points. Now, I had to tally up the points early on, and Chris Washer, because of his finish, had 5,095, and I had to do some math that enable people had to get there. You had to be at least 5,063 or better. And from what I could see, Kyle Miller. Marco Martinez. JT Bryant. Charles Samper. Trent Dunham, Levi McIntyre, Jessica Shelton, they are only ones there that are barely making the border. Everyone else has been eliminated from the contention of the championship, and they are just on the border being eliminated. Now, the way this is possible is this: when we go to FTF, if Washer does not encounter problems, he would finish at least, what I could say, 6 or 7 points ahead of these guys right here that are the ones remaining left, then Chris Washer would clinch the championship early on. Other than that, I just see no other way possible that these guys could really do it. But nonetheless, though, we still have competition alive. here's a look at your results. I just want to thank you guys for watching today's race. If you liked it, be sure to give a like, comment your thoughts on this. Subscribe right there, slide that subscribe button. We'll see you guys later for Chase Race number 9, which we have FTF. Which a lot will be at stake there, especially for the Cup Series. It's do or die. And hopefully Chris Washer, he can survive. It'll be the last time we'll ever run FTF in the NRSL. And it'll be a brand new track they'll take over next season. Until then, we will see you guys later. And until then, peace.